All right, hero comics here. Except so here goes transgender hate mail, homosexual hate mail, atheist hate mail. Yeah, basically, we are going to, after I get through with a certain part, I'm going to have to go through like everything again or something, because apparently my stuff was out of order. And yeah, I'm trying to get to certain places because I'm going to show you off certain just whacked out things that people are saying and trying to justify the transgender lifestyle, you know, and all these other lifestyles that are against the Bible. But yeah, basically, apparently, I had things set to the wrong order, but that's okay. We'll get to that later. Okay. We'll get to that stuff later. But first, I want to continue on with this stuff. All right. So, trigger. Yeah. Did I say that? Yeah. Trigger warning already. Yeah, so, you know, this definitely will be some great stuff. Let's continue on here. Let's see, I say, no, people must learn the truth. Like, someone says, the truth is that you're a sad, pathetic man. Okay, yeah. Man who's fighting over comics for years and thinks garbage because I say it's garbage. Yeah, I know that. You know. Go after the comics, go after the spelling, go after my face, whatever. I said, this stuff. As you follow your orders, then we'll get to the end to a cross. Yeah. Keep your command. You can come to his videos. I'm like, nobody cares because I say what nobody cares what you say. You know? I hate the fact that nobody cares what you say because I say nobody cares what you say. You know, get it through your ear, just go and F off. And because I got rid of that word. No. Someone who's going to a Christian camp soon has faith in Jesus and the Lord. He completely accepts transgender. No, he doesn't. The Bible says that stuff is wrong. Continue on here. And actually knows what it means. That it's wrong. Lying. You know, you do not know what transgender means because I say you don't. You know, he's lying. Stop saying you're spreading the truth when you don't know what the truth is. Because they say you don't know. Because I say you don't know. Transgenderism isn't harmful because I say it's not harmful. Ignore the fact that it is very harmful and people have died, have transitioned, then killed themselves because it still doesn't fix it. It's the problem. Continue on here. You have no proof that it ever was, never could be, other than all the people saying that they are gonna, you know, they have to do this or they'll die, and then they die anyway. It doesn't work. Continue on here. God loves everybody. Transgenders are included in that love, yes, but they don't like what they do. Reread the Bible and then do some research on what transgenderism is. Fear. So I could mention this research, not a simple Google search. Research is going to reliable science of people who study human body sciences. Human body sciences, I have, you know, stuff's wrong. Entire hospital websites approved by government will talk about transgender people or the surgeries they will usually have. But don't do it, don't help them. They will explain why the fixes are necessary. They're not necessary. Completely safe, they're not safe. God approves of love and empathy, and when the trans surgeries happen, humans are helped by other humans. No, they're not. They're hurting other humans. They learn to live with that, what they have. They couldn't be more pleased with all the beautiful people on this earth who strive to form a community in which everyone is comfortable and safe. But unfortunately, I don't know what comfortable is. I don't know about comfortable. You know, that's what he said. You recover from whatever sadness you have in your heart, and know that Jesus and the Lord will forgive you for spreading misinformation. That is the actual information. Sure, they forgive you for spreading misinformation. That's when it's under God's name. Bless. And I say, I am telling you the truth. A woman must not wear men's clothing, nor a man with clothing. The Lord your God detests anyone who does this. In Deuteronomy 22:5. This is in the Bible. Why does God detest this stuff? Lying lives in an abomination to the Lord. They should be always delight. Proverbs 12:22. Why are you okay with people lying about their biological sex and saying that God made a mistake when he made them? You know, there you go. You know. The Bible says there's no. Oh, then the person says, God loves me even though I'm trans. You're going off a translated book instead of the word of the Lord himself. Sounds kind of dumb. You know, I was trying to get to this part. But himself. Well, I say, you're saying the Bible is not the word of God? Also, God does love you, but he does not like lying. And this person said, the Bible isn't an accurate word of God. Because they say it isn't. Ignore the fact that it is. You know, because you basically study the Bible so you can learn how God speaks. And learn how the devil speaks. So when people start talking to you, you can figure out whether they're really talking from God's, you know, following God's ways or following the devil's ways. That's how you do it. You know, yeah. This person is obviously following the devil's ways. He's like, no. Don't read the Bible. Don't read about how the laws that God gave to people to tell them how they live. Don't read about that. Don't read about that because you know that means you're going to be telling us you know, not to do that stuff either. So yeah, don't do that. Good time. So yeah, that's the. I say, I don't love you, I don't like lying. Word of God. It's up for interpretation because I say it is. It has been translated through multiple languages. It has multiple times seeking God himself when in need of something as a serious gender reassignment. Seek God himself when in need of something as serious as gender reassignment. I'll do it by reading the Bible. Like, God himself loves everyone, and he's okay with people doing things to their bodies. No, he's not. There were several verses about not getting, you know, mutilating your genitals, not, you know, lying. So, yeah, I'm sorry, it doesn't work. Well, everyone's okay, people doing things. Everybody knows he's not. How do you think Eve was made? God took a rib out of Adam and made Eve. He accepts procedures when they are to benefit, and gender reassignment surgery and to benefit. Reassignment surgery only benefits, though it doesn't. It destroys. It's bad news. Educate yourself in the actual word of the Lord. What is it? If it's not the Bible, then what is it? That's the issue. If you don't think the Bible is the word of God, what is? You know, what people say? Famous people say? Downgrade. Under the Lord. I don't know. What was it? 120? Click. 119. 120. Those removal of healthy parts of a person is mutilation, I say. If God wanted them to be male, he would have given them male organs. If he wanted them to be female, he would have given them female organs. And we will see who's making fool of themselves. I stand on the solid rock of God's word. What do you stand on? Sand, as we'll see. This person says, see, Alex, you're wrong. God loves me and will continue to support me after my gender reassignment surgery. That's left out. You shouldn't be doing that. You are wrong. I say you're wrong. Goodbye. Your hate is not accepted. It's not accepted. It never will be. Hate of sin is, when the hate of sin is not accepted, you have a problem. And so as a see, Alex, you seem like a terrible person using God as a weapon. The Bible is a two-edged sword. Absolutely heinous. Next, you're saying gay isn't right. It isn't. You know, you're misinformed. Because I say you're misinformed. I've been praying for you. Goodbye. You know, and then I say, of course, my hate of sin will never be accepted. Especially if those who are sinning. And God's word is a weapon. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickednesses in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand the evil day, in the evil day, and having done all to stand. Stand, therefore, having your loins girded about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. And take the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Perseverance and supplication for all saints, Ephesians 6. Are you saying, and you say that you are a saint, a.k.a. Christian, then I will pray for you too. Pray that you start studying the Bible again. That is our instruction manual. You know, I'm saying this, you gotta read the Bible. And she's like, no, you know. Yeah, you do. Also, homosexual acts are forbidden according to the Bible. Do not have sexual relations with a man as one does a woman. That is acceptable. Leviticus 18:22. You know, this person not happy with that. We have to be translated wrong, because I say it has been translated wrong. Man doesn't mean man. It means male of a different age. Like a male. So still male. Like man could be. So still not translated wrong. It means man, do not have sex with other men. So don't do that. No homosexuality. That's what I said. Done. Briefly translated wrong, because I say it has. I already said that. The Bible is against lying for sexual gain, harm, and pedophilia, and homosexual acts. Not transgender homosexuality. Actually, it is. If I were truly, if you were truly a saint, you would have done further research to realize that the English translation is not accurate word of God, because I say it's not. As the world have been changed to translation, do better. And I say, so it's not proven wrong. Someone did not like what it said, because it makes what they do wrong. And then I say, okay, not only do we have that verse that says, thou shalt not lie with mankind as with womankind, it is abomination, Leviticus 18. There is 19. Two angels arrived in Sodom, and at the evening, and Lot was sitting at the gateway of the city. When he saw them, he got up to meet them and bowed down with his face to the ground. My lords, he said, please turn aside to your servant's house. You can wash your feet and spend the night and go on your way in the morning. No, the answer, we'll spend the night in the square. Like, but he insisted strongly, so strongly that they did go with him and entered his house. He prepared a meal for them, baked bread without yeast, and they ate. Hold on. Okay, a little bit of time left. Before they had gone to bed, all the men from every part of the city of Sodom, both young and old, surrounded the house. They called out to Lot, where are the men that came to you tonight? Bring them out so we can have sex with them. Lot went outside to meet them and shut the door behind him and said, no, my friends, do not do this wicked thing. Genesis 19. Homosexual acts are seen as wicked here too. Then we have this, because that, wait, how much time? Okay, see you next time.